Hello and welcome everybody to our 2021 Tailwind for Tools concert series grand finale. Thank you so much for tuning in. We're going to first hear from a talk from Sharlyn Race, and then that will get concert and us the founders of Monarcas. So really glad that everybody's here tonight. I'll start a little bit of back about the recyclery this year for us. It's been pretty like for everybody. So the Recyclery Collective is an educational bike shop that promotes sustainability by giving access to bikes, tools, skills, and opportunities for collaboration. That's our mission, and we've been working at that mission for 15 years now. This year, well, 2020, this past year, there were 2020. We gave away 151 free cyclery bikes thanks to efforts by our remote volunteers and a lot of coordinating of moving bikes around to people's home shops and get parts that to them needed. Door fixing installed walk in of our shop, and there's very traffic during the month. Now we're going to see somebody again. While a lot of our programs had to be closed, it was to have that permanent accessible stand with kit available, and we all had a bike corral installed, and they had our men and will have placed been necessary yet. Open up and the volunteers will be coming and it'll be great. Also, we organized along with our partner at Family Matters around the corner. We organized Black Rides for Black Lives, a protest ride, and that was, it was enjoyable, and a lot of feedback. Like while we were riding past and blocking intersections, we got nothing but good vibes, and so that was a great event. Also started online to keep serving the community, and we sold a whopping 470 bikes this year at prices averaging less than $250. And another little fun highlight that generated some buzz for health art mosaic installations, which inspired a club to go on surprise and see if you can wear the little part of bottles. So that's a bit about the recycling. I'll go ahead and introduce Sharlyn. Sharlyn was actually founding a recycling collective back in 2006. At that time, she ran shops, taught classes, she served as shop manager, and helped set the tone of the organization. As often the case, part of a small team, a new project, Sharlyn wore out of hats. Sharlyn left three to pursue. True skills to make the justice system more equitable. 18, she founded a nonprofit, Chicago community works with education, provides support, being bond for people charged with crimes coming from communities that cannot afford to pay. So as many of you know, in 2020, Illinois passed the free trial fairness, and just this week that Governor Pritzker signed the law. So there's to unpack here, and Sharlyn is going to tell us a bit about the amazing work that this about. There will be a Q&A after her presentation, so please type your questions into the chat. Wonderful volunteer Kate Bender will read all the questions and help us keep the conversation flowing. To tell us about her work with the Chicago Community Bond Fund, get us all up to on the fight for free trials is Sharlyn.
All right. Thank you so much for having me, Zippy, into the Recyclery. I love the melding of these two worlds so much. And there's a ton of misinformation going around about the bill, both the aspects ending money bail, but also all kinds of other reforms that are in the bill. And so I'm really glad that we're here tonight to talk about it. And I just want to also be clear. So I was part of helping start and launch the Bond Fund in 2014, 2015, and I served as Chicago Community Bond Fund's executive director until last month, until the end of January. And so I'm actually here tonight representing the Illinois Network for Pretrial Justice, which is our statewide network that was launched in 2019, building on a multi-year fight to really push for systemic reform. And so the Bond Fund is part of that network, but since I'm not currently working with the Bond Fund, I'm just volunteering still on the policy advocacy and systems change part of that work. And I think I have some time here in the beginning to just talk about the issue before we get to questions. And I just want to give a really brief overview of what money bail is and why this is such a historic change. So every year around the country, there are millions of people who are booked into county jails. Here in Illinois, there are 92 county jails, and more than 250,000 people are admitted to them every year. Almost all of those people are awaiting trial, people in county jails, and the majority of them are there because they can't afford to pay a certain amount of money. And that's what money bail is. It's an amount of money that a judge sets when someone is still unconvicted, presumed innocent, and if someone can pay that amount of money, they're released. And if someone can't afford to pay that money, then they're jailed for days, weeks, months, and years in some cases. And people who are in jail have much worse outcomes, both in their cases and in their lives, than people who are released. And that means they're more likely to be convicted, they receive longer sentences, and then even if they're never convicted, if their case is dismissed or they're found not guilty and they're ultimately released, people still lose their jobs, their housing, in some cases, custody of their children, and even their lives because they were jailed during that pretrial period. And that was never supposed to be the case. The justice system, the criminal legal system, like many people know that phrase, innocent until proven guilty, but that's not how it works when we use money bail, and the majority of people who are given those bails can't afford to pay them. So that's why there's a national movement to end money bail and replace it in many cases with release without having to pay money, so that people who don't have access to wealth and communities that have not had the same opportunities to accumulate wealth in this country, particularly Black, Native, Brown, and other communities of color, but also all poor communities and people, are not disadvantaged systematically and sent deeper into the system and punished more harshly than white communities and people with wealth or access to money who are able to get out simply because of that access to money. So we in Illinois are part of this national movement, and people might know that ending money bail is also part of the Black Lives Matter movement demands that have arisen since 2014, 2013. And in Illinois, we have been working with a broad cross-section of people and organizations since 2016 to eliminate money bail and make sure that in the process of eliminating money bail, that we are reducing pretrial jailing, not just getting rid of money, which is so unfair and is a huge source of racism and racial disparities in the criminal justice system, but it's not the problem alone. It's actually the jailing. So as I said, I'm here tonight with the Illinois Network for Pretrial Justice. I think there was a link dropped in. Our website is endmoneybond.org. You can read more about our work over the last 5 years. There are more than 30 organizations that are members of the Illinois Network for Pretrial Justice. And as Zippy said, just earlier this year in January, the Illinois legislature passed the bill that was written by advocates, supported by and pushed for by community members, including people who've been previously impacted by pretrial jailing. And Governor Pritzker signed that bill into law last week, on Monday of last week. So we're celebrating a week of the bill being signed. The central provisions of the bill that end money bail won't actually go into effect until January 2023. And I think we're going to be putting a link for you to see to a one-pager, two sides of a one-pager, that actually explain what the bill does, because it does a lot of different things in addition to ending money bail, all of which are designed to make the system fairer, to make it more transparent, to make it reviewable, and to make it a better system that serves everyone and reduces our use of jail in Illinois, which has been a great source of destabilization in the communities that are most targeted by criminalization. So another thing that I want to highlight while I'm talking to you before we answer questions is that we have an Action Network link. We have an automatic email that you can send to your state senator and your state representative, and also Governor Pritzker, to either thank them for supporting the Pretrial Fairness Act, our bill ending money bail, or to say, hey, you didn't vote on our bill, or you voted no on the bill, and we're disappointed because you were on the wrong side of history, and you were standing for a system that lets money be the determining of who is in a cage and who is released while they're still awaiting trial. And I also want to be clear, if you look for the Pretrial Fairness Act in the legislature, you're not going to find it that way, because it passed as part of a big omnibus bill. Omnibus just means many things combined, that was supported by the Illinois Legislative Black Caucus. And so the bill number that actually passed and that was signed into law last week is House Bill 3653. And that is also on the handout that we're putting out. So you can see that if you click on the link through the chat. And you can also find all that information on the Illinois Network for Pretrial Justice's website and moneybond.org. And as I said, there's a lot of misinformation, a lot of inaccurate statements about what the law will or will not do in Illinois. And so I'm excited for the question and answer portion of this so that we can really get into any questions that people who are watching have. Got it. If somebody else can read questions, or if I can even see questions, I'm fine to just respond to them. So the question was, what can we be doing every day to help advocate for change? Or really, since we just had this tremendous victory that was the result of thousands of people around the state taking action over the last 5 years, now that we've won, what we have to do is we have to defend our victory. We have to defend the Pretrial Fairness Act. We have to defend the other criminal justice reform measures that were included in the omnibus bill that Governor Pritzker signed last week, because there are people, particularly law enforcement, but also Republican legislators, who want to take away those reforms, right? There's a legislative session right now through the end of May at which bills will probably be introduced that would start to undo some of these reforms that haven't even taken effect yet. And one of the things that has been pretty disturbing about the information about the bill is people saying this bill is bad for domestic violence victims, domestic violence survivors, survivors of other kinds of interpersonal violence. And in fact, there are a number of leading organizations that advocate against sexual and domestic violence that work with victims and survivors day in and day out, who are part of helping craft the bill and are supportive of the Pretrial Fairness Act. So the Illinois Coalition Against Domestic Violence, the Chicago Alliance Against Sexual Exploitation, and the network advocating against domestic violence are all supporters of the bill. And I will find a link and drop it in here so that you can read Case's statement on the bill and help share accurate information, help share that one pager, help refer people to the voices of advocates, people who are working against violence, and people who are working against our very, very punitive and very racist criminal legal system as it is now. Because the reality is the people who oppose these changes are the same people who oppose all reform efforts, all things that would make our criminal legal system a little bit less harsh, a little bit less racist. And let's be clear that that's all it is, right? We're not done. We have more work to do, but this is an improvement. And we do need people to call or use the email tool and this action network link. And you don't have to write an original statement to your state legislators or the governor. There's something that's already written and it already factors in how they voted. But they're getting so many negative messages, right? The sort of right-wing trolls are much more active online than people who are supportive. So it's really important for the people who have stood up for fairness and improvements and stood up for and alongside and with communities that have been targeted by criminalization, that they receive positive feedback, that they get affirmation for what they have done by voting for this. And I'm also going to share a link to a Chicago Sun-Times article that just came out today that interviews four people, three of whom were incarcerated in Cook County Jail solely because they could not afford to pay their bonds. And the fourth person is the wife of one of the other people interviewed. And they're all in the story explaining why they were part of advocating for the Pretrial Fairness Act and what it means that the bill is passed. So I think in the day-to-day, if you're hearing misinformation, you can share accurate information. You can be strong and consistent and bold in the fight for racial justice and economic justice. And you can also share accurate information about the bill and about the issues in general. Sure. So the question was, what is the intersection between transportation justice and the Pretrial Fairness Act or the movement to end money bail? And I would say that one is just the people, right? The communities that are served by the recyclery, the communities that are disadvantaged by a car-centric culture or by our current distribution of public transit resources that disproportionately benefit people in wealthier and whiter areas and leave large portions of our city and our suburbs without reliable or frequent transportation service that's affordable. Those are the same communities that are targeted by the criminal legal system for arrest, prosecution, and jailing. And so we're talking about supporting and uplifting the same individuals, the same communities. And I think also in general, what we're talking about is increasing everyone's ability to live a life with dignity and autonomy, where people can make their own choices. People can travel freely and safely, whether that's with a reliable and affordable transportation option, like a bicycle, or whether it means being able to travel without being stopped by police, and risking going to jail for things as simple as driving on a suspended license, which is very frequently the result of not being able to pay a fine associated with a ticket in the first place, right? So it's, in many cases, there are direct links to poverty. We know that having reliable transportation helps people be able to get and maintain employment. So all of this is really about being able to remove the burden of oppressive systems as much as we can, and to support people with resources so that they can really self-determine what they want to do and ultimately continue to build towards that world where everyone has what they need to not only survive, but also to thrive. No, I don't have anything else to add. It sounds like that's all the questions. So I just want to thank you all again for having me and remind you that you can also follow the work of the movement to end money bond and the movement for pretrial justice in Illinois by signing up for our newsletter. That's on our website, endmoneybond.org. You can also follow the Coalition to End Money Bond and the Illinois Network for Pretrial Justice on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. And if you do that, you'll be able to follow up with people. You'll be able to follow up with the campaign as there are new developments, because there are going to be actions that we're asking people to take on an ongoing way, all the way through the full implementation of the bill in January 2023 and probably after that. So we really are grateful for the win and everyone whose labor made it happen. And we also know that the fight isn't over. So we want to continue to have people engaged and following and being involved however they can. And thank you to that end for being here tonight and for supporting the recycling.
Great. Thanks so much, Sharlyn, for joining us to talk a little bit more about the campaign to end cash bail in Illinois. Definitely, if you're just joining us, take a look at the links that are in the chat to learn more. And we're really glad to have such a great community of folks who have been a part of the Recyclery that can come and speak on these really important issues. We are now about to hear from Mercedes and Ira Connie, the two lead members of their amazing band, Son Monarcas. Who are such vibrant and generous members of the Chicago music scene. They weave together different Latin music traditions like son jarocho and cumbia, all with their own style. Their activism comes through music as they bridge borders in all kinds of ways. I hope everyone will someday get the chance to see their full band in action once that's safe. Tonight, we have this amazing intimate duo streaming right to your living room. So please get ready for the son jarocho and cumbia and soul stylings of Son Monarcas. Take it away. Living through day and night.
Monarcas. So happy to be here with you guys today. This is Irecani Ferreira on the Requinto Jarocho, and my name is Mercedes, or Mercedes Inez, here with Son Monarcas, supporting the amazing charitable things that they are doing in the world. So we hope that you donate to the Recyclery. So please enjoy some tunes. That was a tune, an original tune called Caminando por la Arena. And this next tune is actually a very famous tune from Chile, and it's called Mira Niñita. And we are dedicating this to Quetzalí.
Ah. ven con ojos de cristal y papel soñado en la piel.
Oh,
so we're going to do an oldie but a goodie, not too old. I think a lot of you will know it. And it became very popular over the summer, bringing hope to a lot of people. So we're going to go with it and have fun with it. So if you like singing along at home, we hear you in our hearts. There you go.
Drives you mad in the stillness of remembering what you had.
guys. So we're going to now do an original tune. It's coming out on our next album that will be out this summer. And we got a bunch of singles coming out before that. And we're also collaborating with the Chicago Children's Choir on this original tune of ours called Volar Conmigo, which means fly with me. And if you want to sing at home, feel free. The refrain goes like this. Volar, 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 volar conmigo. Then it says, volar, 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 como la mariposa. Like the butterfly. So fly, fly, fly with me. Volar, volar, volar conmigo. Volar, 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 como la mariposa. Like the butterfly. And we are Son Monarcas. And the monarch butterfly represents a symbol of freedom to move, to migrate, and that migration is beautiful and not something to be afraid of. And we hope that that can be something that you take away from us when you hear our music, to not be afraid of immigrants anywhere, because we all come from immigrants everywhere. So here's a little bit of Volar Conmigo. Thank you. We hope you enjoyed that one. Volar Conmigo will be coming out very soon, in the next few months, also with the Chicago Children's Choir accompanying us. All right, so we're going to do another an original tune. It's a little older. This one's called La Sirena de la Frontera from our first album of the same name. That's the title of the album. La Sirena de la Frontera, or the Mermaid of the Frontier or the Border. A mermaid is half human and half fish, and often that's what most children of immigrants or immigrants feel, part of two different worlds but at the same time. And so that's a little bit also a nod to my hometown of El Paso, Texas, El Paso, Texas, El Chuco, that lives on the border. La Sirena de la Frontera.
La sirena,
Thank you so much. That was La Sirena de la Frontera from our first album. So we are Son Monarcas again. So happy to be here with you guys. And we're going to do another tune. This is a little cover of a tune by a very fun duo that we love, named Rodrigo and Gabriela. And this one is called Tamacun. We're going to be featuring Mr. Irakani Ferreira over here on this instrument that is called the Requinto Jarocho, which is an instrument from Veracruz, Mexico, on the Gulf Coast of Mexico. Son Monarcas. So happy to be with you guys tonight. We hope you guys are having a lovely night. We're going to do a couple more tunes before we finish. We'll do one for my beloved Texas, which can get a bad rap often. But not everyone in Texas is bad, just like not everyone in the world is bad, and not all humanity is bad. So, you know, I just want to give a shout out to everyone in Texas and all the things that they've been through in the last few weeks, all the craziness and messed upness. And we're going to do a tune, a very fun tune, by a really awesome band that I love called Krongbin. They're out of Houston, and that they did with a very amazing singer from Texas as well, named Leon Bridges. And this tune is called Texas Sun. Thank you. goes out to all my Texans out there. And we're going to do one more tune for you. This tune is called La Bamba. I think you know it. It's about 350 years old. If you didn't know it, that. Not originally by Richie Valens. No. It was actually a very old son jarocho, a type of music from Mexico along the Gulf Coast in the state of Veracruz, a type of music called son jarocho. And we're going to do a little bit of a medley for you as we leave you. We are Son Monarcas. We have Irecani Ferreira on the Requinto Jarocho. My name is Mercedes Ines. Again, we want to give a shout out to Kevin for making this possible with the sound and the video. Hey, Kevin. And also, Sippy, you're doing good things out there.
Yeah.
Love you so much. And please donate, guys. These are really important charities that need your help. So please do your part, whatever you can. $1, $5, $100. You do you what you can do. And we're gonna do one more tune, and we hope you enjoy this one. And if you feel like singing along, do it. Dance and sing like nobody's watching. Thank you. Thank you guys so much. If you like our music, check us out at sonmonarcas.com on Facebook, Instagram, at sonmonarcas. We want to again thank everyone who made this possible. Please donate what you can, guys. And thank you for tuning in. Adios.
All right, great. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us. Thank you so much to Son Monarcas. Thank you so much to Sharlyn Grace for speaking with us about the successful campaign to end cash bail. Thank you so much to all of our donors and being here to support us. We are very close to our 10K goal, and we couldn't do that without the support of everyone here and these great bands and speakers that have been with us throughout the past couple of weeks. So thank you once again to Son Monarcas and to Sharlyn Grace and to everyone for joining us. Have a great night.